we're going to do a little exercise in leadership, hydration, and being honest with ourselves so that we can be better leaders. All of us know the guy or the gal that says, I hiked 25 miles this weekend, 60-pound pack, uphill both ways in the snow, on one leg, with no food. When you're looking at them, it's kind of hard to tell if they could even touch their toes. Or maybe they're telling the truth and they're actually mountain goats masquerading as humans. Most of us fall somewhere in between. We all think that we can carry more weight than we really can. We all think we can hike farther than we really can, unless it's something that you do all the time. There's really only one way to get in shape to go hiking, and that's to go hiking. Yes, working out the gym and weights and squats and all the things that we do with cardio, all those things are all beneficial. Proper diet is very beneficial. Then a lot of times the next topic becomes, how much water do you need to drink per day? And we'll get into all that in a different section, but the reality of it is, if you feel like you're thirsty, you're already being dehydrated. It's not true that if you pee and your pee is a different color other than clear, they're dehydrated. Maybe you loaded up on vitamins, could be something you ate, could be a kidney problem, could be a lot of different things, right? But if you're not peeing, you're dehydrated. A lot of this gets down to physical fitness. If you eat a lot of fruit, if you have a healthy diet, if you're super physically active, you're mega super strong, right? You're gonna have a higher level of pain tolerance, which includes hydration, more than somebody that's an office jockey thinks they can throw on a 60-pound pack and go hump it. They're gonna be gassed and dehydrated immediately because their body's not conditioned. That's one of the reasons why we started out with, let's eat better before we start all this other stuff. This is a simple way to gut test yourself. I'm not here to criticize you. I'm not here to make you feel bad. I'm here to help you be successful in your journey and to become a grassroots civil defense hiking leader so that you can share what we talk about here door to door, and then that spreads and goes shore to shore, and we're all stronger. You and I are the grassroots true civil defense, the real homeland security for our country. One little bottle of water, right? This is half a liter. It's typically about 0.9 fluid ounces. This is about 1 pound. Does that vary a little bit? Yeah, it does. So what? 1 pound. So take your backpack out and go buy 3 cases of these. 2.5 cases get stuffed down into your backpack. That's 60 bottles. That's 60 pounds. Now, once you take the other 12, right? And put 6 of them in a bag for one hand and 6 of them in a bag for the other hand. The other 12, well, that could represent walking around with a rifle, right? Or that could just represent carrying a little extra weight that you might carry in your hands, like a binocular, walking staff, so on and so forth. Now you need to go and pick, like, let's say 10 miles out. Load up your car. Have a friend drive you 10 miles away from your house and drop you and your backpack filled with water off. And start walking home. Be honest with yourself. See how you did. It's only 60 pounds and you do this all the time, right? It's not in a bad weather condition and it's not uphill both ways. It's probably flat because you're living in an urban environment. That is a good measure of how well or what kind of shape you're truly in. Now think of it this way, it's only 60 pounds. Our valiant warriors in the military carry more than that every day, all day long. Okay, so that was a quick gut check for you. Now what I really want you to do is, let's just be honest. Maybe put 20 bottles of water in your backpack and just start out with 1 mile. Half a mile away from your house, half a mile back. If that's too easy, well then walk faster. If that's too easy, add more weight and start walking farther. Now when you get home, I don't want you to immediately plant your butt down on the couch and start drinking a beer or loading up full of all the fluids that weren't in your backpack. I want you to be honest with yourself and for the next 12 to 24 hours, only drink what you brought. Why do I ask you to do this? That tells you that teaches you exactly how much water you need. Now, obviously, I might drink a different amount of water than you drink. I might carry more or less than what you carry. Most of us here in America, including myself, could stand to lose 20 pounds. If we start hiking all the time, even if it's just a backpack with water in it, guess what? If we get healthier, we lose a little bit of weight. We lose a little bit of weight, that backpack is, well, it's no longer as heavy as it used to be. And we're just better people all the way around. This little bottle of water equals one of these hip flasks made of plastic that you can get at an army surplus store. Now, we've all seen these made out of metal, and it might have some kind of Russian insignia on there, and you can put your vodka in there. Yeah, I like to have a little nip out in the woods too, but alcohol dehydrates you. It's not really a good idea. But one of these little plastic containers is basically a small canteen, right? It's one water bottle. It's small, it's thin, and it's light. If you have little kids, this is something you can put in their backpack and it's not too heavy. You can load these up in your cargo pants, one on each side, and it doesn't get in your way like one of these bigger canteens does. Now, basically, a canteen is two water bottles. So two water bottles and like a little bit more, but it's basically two water bottles. I only mention this as a quick exercise to think about water and weight and our true conditioning level. Another thing to throw in is the obvious one. If I'm hiking around in winter, my water requirements are going to be different than if I'm hiking around in summertime. Now, summertime for you might be hiking in 110 degrees in Phoenix, ascending Camelback Mountain before 9 in the morning so you don't get carted away by a helicopter. Or it could be hiking around in Juneau, Alaska, well, where you're pretty much just trying to fight the bugs away and make it back out without your feet getting too wet. Now, for me, I have four full seasons. I have different water requirements all year round. The only way to truly learn these isn't from reading a book where somebody else says you have to have 2 liters of water per hour or whatever it is. It's how your body reacts. And your body is going to act and react completely differently based on the foods that you put into it on a daily basis and your overall conditioning going into that hike. And remember, water is probably the heaviest thing we're going to carry in our backpacks.